Welcome back, dear friends of Tactical Gameplay, to another episode of Xenonauts X Division with me, Daga. We have our first in-between waves thingy since real-time months. I just wanted to catch up on like the how the air game's going right now, what I need to do. Didn't really do that because it's also so drawn out. But I looked at like two little curious fights. Yeah, we are in the process of bringing our troops back, and also in the process of restructuring the bases. Maybe since this is going to be like a no tactical fights episode, most likely, because I'm gonna do the first air game encounters, and then I'm gonna most likely stop when it's about equipping the teams. I think I'm gonna quickly talk about what I plan with the air game restructurings, just so you guys can and girls can basically see what I'm thinking with respect to the geo strategic position we're in and where I want us to be. Basically this is the of course the globe. Basically we have, I feel like, 2.5 clusters here. We have the American cluster, so these bases will have to defend the airspace over both Americas. Then we have the European African theater, which is this one, and we have the Asian theater. And in the Asian theater, since there's so much landmass, at least main base and maybe Northern Africa, Europe can defend it as well. And I've built Europe base mainly because main base here will only have one squad of like one triplet of planes that are not dropships, and one hangar for production of aircraft, which we're then gonna redistribute as they come out of the factory, basically, or out of the workshops, which is a very German thing, right? If you look at Second World War, but basically this is it, right? So I need sufficient dogfight and bomber capability here. I need sufficient here, and okay one here with the occasional support from main base. So that's basically it, what I'm aiming at. So with that, what I want to, like, very broadly, I'm distributing into fighter squads and bomber squads. This is the only thing that really matters for me, and everything in between, like the medium ones, you can also send a bomber squad. So what signifies a bomber squad is that they have two general purpose planes who have anti-missiles, or that have anti-missiles. This is the crucial thing for bombers, because they attack huge aircraft which normally sport some sort of torpedoes or missiles. So we need anti-missiles for that, and then also we need the high damage of the torpedoes, basically. A bonus would be something like the Piranha missile launcher, but we don't have planes who have two light hard points, I think. So that would be like a bonus for support aircraft for bombers, but I don't. Let's take a look at the aircraft actually, because I'm not sure where are the hard points here. One cannon, one normal, two cannon normal. Yeah, okay, yeah. A Firebird is the only thing I know of that has two normal hard points, right? And a Foxtrot has one heavy, and that's that. But maybe one of the planes we have been neglecting to... can I see the Lancer aircraft here? Sonder? Can I see it here? Two missile type weapons. Okay, so Sonder might be the thing that helps us here. to even better equip these bomber auxiliary aircraft, one with anti-missiles and one with something like hyper-missiles. That would be the best thing. But strictly speaking, like one of the auxiliary craft can have a hyper-missile, and that should be enough. It's not often that they, like for the very, very big UFOs, which have 360 vision with bad stuff, it's not very, very sensible to get in close for the hypermissiles, right? I'd rather have like two of the four torpedoes only going through and flying multiple sorties. Yeah, for that we need bomber cover everywhere, and also there's fighter triplets, right, which we now have the Corsairs for, formerly the Azeros, which are also still in service here. But I'm planning on switching to Corsairs. Also, I'm not equipping them with Mausers anymore, even though they have like the best burst damage, but I think the overall damage of the plasma blaster, focus lens, and sonar pulse, Magstorm, like all the stuff that we currently have equipped, will be better than the Mausers, right? If we look at here, this has basically 300 damage over 30, like maybe 1 second. Am I like this divided by 60 would be 200. Yeah, it's less than a second, right? 20. Am I divided by 60? So 150 divided by 2 by 6 would be 25. So it's a bit more than a second that it needs to uncharge everything. But it's only 300 damage, whereas when we look maybe at this thing, we have 25 times 32 damage, so this is like 600, 850 and a bit, 900. So this is 3 times the damage, even though we only shoot 5 shots per second, so this is like 6 and a bit seconds worth of stuff. But the Corsairs are also faster, more nimble, so we get behind the enemy medium planes more often. Mauser is still sufficient, like if you have two of them against the heavy fighters, but only barely, right? And it will not drag into phase 3. So I'm looking at maybe more of the focus lens. Let's see here, 350 damage, 2 seconds, 700 damage. So this is like one shot of this should kill a heavy fighter, or no, two shots of this should kill a heavy fighter. If a Mauser, if two Mausers basically kill one heavy fighter and a bit, right? So this is 600 damage that they do. This should, if you equip two of them instead, this should bring down two heavy fighters, which would be awesome. And same with something like this, right? This is 400, almost 800 damage, 720, and it shoots that 5 per second, so this is 8 seconds. Okay, it's not that good. Sonar pulse is special because you can basically fly by the enemy fighters. You don't have to have them in your narrow front cone, so this is also fine, and it shoots rather quickly. Magstorm, it's around the same as the hypervelocity fighter beam, right? Yeah, a bit less damage, but that's okay. Okay, yeah, so this is basically the let's look at the plasma blaster. It has less range, actually. It has less damage. Is it just cheaper to build, or what? It has the same degree. Okay, I don't know. Yeah, it's not as much damage, but it's comparable. So maybe it's just a cheaper Yeah, 6 alloys and 2 Elenium, it doesn't need special stuff like weapon systems. But then again, Magstorm doesn't either, it's just a bit more expensive here. 2 A in light weapon systems, 2 A in light weapon systems, yeah. So these are basically the premium stuff which you only scale with shot down enemy planes that you then also take apart. And these ones are the cheaper alternatives, but I think I prefer Magstorm here. Let's do the math real quick. That's again, I know I already did, but that's I think 720, and this is more, this is 720 plus 2 times 24, so it's 780, something like 780. Okay, yeah, so fighter squads are basically anti-fighter and also like anti-medium ships, and I'm planning on having 4 bomber, 4 fighter squads distributed over these bases, and I'm taking also into account that this base is still being built up right now, so I'm putting less into this. It's steamed 1 fighter, 1 bomber, 1 fighter, 2 bombers, and 2 fighter, 1 bombers. So if we have a look at this base, it's building the necessary infrastructure right now, as is, no, North America already has the 9 hangars which it needs, but it has a bit of misdistribution of stuff. It needs far more corsairs in the future. It has 1 fighter too few for fighter squads, and 2 like if you take the what's its face, the Firebird, as one of them, then I guess it has 2 fighter squads and 1 bomber squad consisting of 3 Foxtrots, so it more or less has that, but I'd rather have like only 1 Foxtrot with 2 auxiliary planes here. And so this is the principle which we're following right now. Okay, then for Europe we have Europe base, which will have let's talk about Lupus. So main base only will have 1 bomber squad, because it also has the 2 dropships and it's already full with workshops and stuff, and also these antenna things and med bay and garage, so it's basically full. We won't get more than 1 squad in here. Africa base will have 2 fighters and 1 bomber. So this, like, basically it has to cover this whole southern thing, so it needs to have a good fighter presence. And Europe will have at some day 2 fighters, 2 bomber squads, but this is our most long shot here, right? And then for the Asia Australia or Australasia theater here, which is also partly covered by Zenoni Lupus bomber squad, as we already said, we have 2 fighter, 1 bomber, and 1 fighter, 2 bomber. The reason why I think this is sufficient is also because they have so much water here, little landmass if you compare it to the theater over here. And like in this big landmass, Europe and Zenoni Lupus will be able to help out, basically. Okay, so that's our quick excursion into that. I'm waiting for the alien reactors right now. I've already looked into it. It should drop soon, I hope. And okay, there's plasma pistol, nice. 15 to 20% more damage, which is good. Damage of 90. Let's and precision plasma, okay. I think, yeah, it has the higher precision. I think this is actually a thing we might consider producing. But we'll have to basically look into what we really want to do. AN reactor is already at excellent. Let's look here. So let's maybe... maybe start with the Sonder. Let's look what we what else we have. We have the civilian data hack, which will bring us more ballistic stuff. With some data hack, there might be plasma Mark III dropping, but I'm not like the caster is the LMG, right? And the cannon is the explodey thing cannon. We have a couple of interrogations still to do. Shock rifle might be something worthwhile. Advanced chem gas, I don't know what this leads to. We could also look at the spear cannon. And basically all this stuff is phase 3 stuff, which we won't start on unless we have the phase 3 specialist. So I'm torn between putting more scientists into AN reactor, which have diminishing returns, right? So every scientist I'm putting in here is just 65% as efficient with decreasing when compared to the first one. Officer vivisection. I mean, vivisections of civilians are okay. Alien officer interrogation is the oh, we already do the shotgun here, which is the shotgun. I think this is a better one, better alternative to the shock pistol, which is kind of underwhelming, I feel. But I didn't use it enough to really say. We're gonna do the Robodoc terror analysis. I'm gonna trust myself with putting these things on here, and I'm gonna distribute the scientists to them. Okay. I've looked into. Let's look into the pistols and stuff before I do my new point. So plasma pistol has a range of 6, damage of 65 with one shot 20 and 35 accuracy. This has a range of 6 still, damage of 75, so 10 more, and 24 and 40. 17 and 23%. Okay, it shoots faster and it has higher accuracy, which is a baller, right? Higher damage, more accuracy. This is definitely an upgrade for the shield units to carry. Since we're not producing like energy-based shotgun stuff, because plasma doesn't have that, I think. This is the LMG. This is the cannon. We don't do that here. The main loadout for shield units should be these pistols and mag shotguns, right? Shotguns Mark II here, carbines. Yeah, that should be that. So that's that, and also we have the plasma sniper rifle. Let's look at the let's compare that with the Mag 1 pistol, like really quick what we had right now. It has a higher range. It has like almost half the damage, like 60%, and it has less accuracy, but the rushed mode is good. It's the same percentage time units, I think. And it has the triplet shot if we have the time units to spare. So with the triplet shot it would get almost as much. It has like two. Yeah, it has the same raw damage output than compared with the Mark II plasma pistol, basically. But kinetic armor is more prevalent, right? We know that it has more suppression due to the triplet shot, which is nice, but it's basically corner case. It's not so much. We should rely on the miniguns for suppression, basically. This one has no mitigation. This one has a bit of mitigation, and the Mark II should have more mitigation, I reckon. Okay, yeah, so the plan stands for that. let's look at, maybe we compare it also with this one, right? Oh, it has half the damage, double the range. Great accuracy, same. So this is basically a mid-range pistol, right? If we were to equip our soldiers with Mag Mark II pistols, this would be the secondary weapon we carry, right? But it has little damage, so it's not ideal for that. Let's look at the sniper. Range of 32, which is insane. 85 damage. And pretty high accuracy, 60, 105, 130. It has basically half the damage. 180 damage. I don't know anymore what this one has. 85. Okay, so it's less than, it's more than double the damage. But less accuracy. We're at 60, 105, 130 in the laser rifle. So this one is for really accurate soldiers with who do high damage. I think the firing modes should be the same. Yeah, it's the same. Same distribution. Okay, and over this it's a damage and accuracy increase. Yeah. Which is nice. And also these firing modes cost more. So if you look at it from a game design standpoint, this basically conveys what it should, as far as I'm aware, and what is also like in my liking. So these are the Mark I's are basically the prototype weapons. They don't unlock the full potential. The Mark II's are the normal standard issue stuff basically. Which you then mass produce, but which cost more hard to get resources. So this is the thing which you will be working on. And the Mark III are basically premium upgrade variants of this, which you have to go to great lengths to get, and which might not be worth it, right? If only if you have the resources to spare for that, and only for some weapons, which I like. I'm really fond of that. Okay, so these ones are also stuff we might want to produce. What are we producing right now? We are producing plasma rifles Mark II, which is a really good thing to do. I think we can't produce any more worthwhile planes. We can't. Foxtrots, we have enough. Azeros, we don't want to. And for these ones we need control systems, but that's something we care about later. So AN reactors, where we were on researching. Do we need more plasma batteries here? We have four now, that's enough. Mostly. If they are current tech, four of them have a high chance to bring down any attacking aircraft. I really wish they had some kind of air coverage here, right? Even if it's just a couple hundred kilometers, maybe. Which sounds excessive if you think about it, but if it has like a small radius like this one on the map, it would be cool if it basically also shot at planes that come in here. Maybe with decreasing accuracy the farther they are, and the higher they are. AN reactors, it unlocks predator armor and it unlocks basically the plasma torpedoes for us. I checked before again because I'm anticipating that this will happen right now. But for the predator, we still need a civilian engineer. I figured out that we don't have one yet, which is pretty bad. So this should be our focus, right? We just got insane amounts of Andron missions. So that's that. Okay, let's look at alien UFOs. If we can... We have a landing ship which has four light weapon systems, so two more planes to equip. And they need one basic control systems. Okay, so this is really good. We have the funds at least for until the next or And a wave after that. Extreme landing ship. Okay. Yeah, we captured the second landing ship, right? That's why we have that. That's nice. That's so good. Feels good, man. take the same to disassemble, okay. Let's disassemble this one. To bring our air force up to scratch. Oh yeah, what I wanted to do actually is distribute from main base two of these heavy fighters because we don't need them. Let's see, I just equipped them with their weaponry. And I can relocate them now even though they're not full health. But I can only relocate them to Northern Africa and I want them in Central North America. Central America has one bomber squad and it wants two. North America has these Foxtrots but also wants a bomber squad. So what I'm gonna do here is relocate Foxtrots to somewhere where they can stay. Can we do two of them? Nope. Okay, no free hangars. Which is also a problem should one of our bases be taken over. I think we want these lower health ones over there. And now we take another Foxtrot from... not here, not there, not here. This might take a while to repair, right? And they... yeah, basically they have one Azero squad and one mixed squad of Firebird, Corsair and Azeros. Let's send one Azeros instead to main base and bring them their heavy fighter, which is not a straight upgrade, but it's sufficient. Like with this ragtag squad, I feel it's better to have a heavy fighter in there instead of a fire, or like it's the same instead of an Azeros. It depends on the situation where they find themselves in. And we're building new hangars, so this should be like in 5 days' time. We have the new one. Okay, so shotgun has 120 damage. Let's look at the shock pistol. Is this shock? No, shock charge, shock grenade, shock pistol. It has only has 20, yeah, okay. Range of 8 meters though. Ammo cap 6, the shotgun has ammo cap 2. But it does 6 times the damage with very low range. Yeah, I'm more fond of this. Because I'm already most likely going close to stuff I want to capture. So, this is done. And now I'm actually fearing that we might not do the reactor before the next wave hits, but we are gonna see. Terror soldier interrogation. I don't know if this brings us more damage against the terror soldiers, which would be good. Basic terror up. So these are all like giving us at most some data hacks, right? And we have enough of them. We are already on to two of them. Plasma cannon and caster I don't really care about right now. And I don't think they are stuff that hinders us from getting Mark III. I'm not 100% sure, but I think we're gonna let that come to us, and we're gonna instead. I don't think this brings us anything. What does it do? Disassemble AM power source. Yeah. Okay. We can get rid of power sources like that. Power sources that we no longer need. But we can also sell them for funds, which is most often. What did we do here? Why am I in the screen? Oh, we can produce the shotgun, right? 3 energy cores. We need more cores, so we need to disassemble something here. Looking mostly at Andron and Mech. Yeah, because the RoboDogs bring so many cores. We can put these in, right? We can do like 10 of them and then after that see how weapons production goes. I mean, even 5 of them would be enough actually for now. For new weaponry. Yeah, there's the ship done. I'm looking at more Corsairs here. I think Central America needs more Corsairs. Northern Africa definitely needs more Corsairs. But we also need more more hangars, right? Before I can send this Corsair anywhere, I need more hangars. But we're gonna have to produce weapons for it, most likely anyway. 3 light engines. What does this thing take? 1 light engine. Yeah, still we're gonna produce the Corsairs. And then we're gonna do this because with the plasma rifles we have a good damage spike, I feel. And there it is. Now let's see what we can equip here. 1 focus lens, which is good. 2 focus lenses, which is even better. And then after this is done, I think we find out that we can't relocate it, but we might scrap an F-17 for that. And now for production, we can't forget to do something like this. Advanced stun gas, okay. Our version isn't quite as potent as the alien one. Stun grenade, stun rocket, which is nice. We have the shock grenade also, right? I'm not 100% sure if this advanced stun grenade. I mean, it might do more stun, right, than the shock grenade. But let's do the rocket first. A couple of these can really do us good in high stakes missions, like if we encounter a civilian engineer, for example. Mag pistol Mark II. Let's compare these 2 ballistic cores and 4 alloys. Let's compare these, but only after we've put something else in here. Terror soldier interrogation, for example. As I said, I'm not 100% sure if it gives us more damage against them. I don't think so. I think the vivisection is the thing that gives us. Five scientists left. Let's do the Lancer aircraft instead. Maybe we will have the funds to also replace Foxtrot with these. Should be nice. Let's compare the pistols. There. Mag pistol, Mark 1. We had prior to this 8.45. 25-30, 8-55, 35-35. Okay, so it has also more accuracy. It's the same time to shoot, and it has more damage and good mitigation. It even has 10 mitigation on top, which is nice. So this might make it actually viable as a tool even against kinetic resistant enemies as a kill tool. Ammo cap of 12, I think that's the same, right? Yeah, weight is the same. Okay, yeah, it doesn't look too bad. We might. I'm fond of the shotgun weapons because they also stun and they do vastly more damage, right? The range is slightly higher than this one, but here we have no good replacement weapon in forms of shotguns. So I think I'm gonna stick with these as like weapons for the scouts, as it is here, or similar stuff. Okay, so not really envision producing many of these. there's the Robodog Soldier Corps. So now we are gonna have to look at what we want to produce in terms of weaponry. Let's see. What I think I want the most are more of these mech carbines Mark II. We have a couple Mark I. Same kinetic damage, but more pellets. More accurate shots, which isn't really a concern, but might be. Shock of 35. Yeah, I mean, it's no really necessary upgrade if we think about it. For our scouts, which are like these sniper scouts, which are high accuracy soldiers, like Karen here, or I mean, there are even better examples, but you know what I mean. Sorry, Karen. are there? Do I not have high accurate? Oh, potato. Potato is around the same. But I think the armor also boosts. The buzzard armor also. No, it doesn't boost accuracy. Okay, never mind. Yeah, okay. But for our highest accuracy soldiers, I think the sniper rifle is okay. Even though it has less range, but maybe 5 rifles is a bit little right now. Maybe we should actually stick to more of them. How many? We have 3 of these and 2 of these. This is also a bit on the low end. Pistol wise, we're also pretty low. So most likely pistols, shotguns, and rifles, right? We only have 1 plasma rifle Mark I and 5 of these now. We have some. Well, we actually don't have mech rifles, okay. I mean, we have some laser rifles for the lower end troops, but their damage really isn't great, even though they're Mark III, right? I'm inclined to rather get closer and damage them that way, or have dedicated snipers maybe for farther damage. Yeah. Let's produce more rifles, some pistols. Let's actually start with the pistols. Plasma weapons. I wish you could reorder these things. That would be good. Plasma pistols, 2 of 11 energy cores and negligible amounts of alloys. Oh yeah, we have the plane should be re-equipped, the Corsair, right? Yeah. And yeah, we can't put it anywhere, but we can think about decommissioning some F-17s, like in Indochina. Indochina should have 2 fighter squadrons. They have 1 of these. Yeah, so let's start filling them up with Corsairs. F-17. Oh, this has anti-missiles, right? And it's the only. No, we have a Firebird and we have a heavy fighter, which suffices as 1 bomber. And this doesn't cost anything, so I'm not gonna unequip it. They even have only the normal anti-missiles. I should put the titanium anti-missiles on here. Actually, I have to go through all the planes maybe for that, since it doesn't seem to do it automatically. Yeah, this normal anti-missile. Let's put this one on. This one already has one. This one has one. Titanium. Good. Here I think we were right now. Titanium doesn't have one. Titanium. And then we are. No, we still have 1 base here. Okay. Yeah. So, Northern Africa, right? Was it Northern Africa where we. No, Indochina was where I wanted to decommission this thing. This thing? This thing. But it has 0 ammo because I Stupidly also re-equipped the anti-missile. If I put it back, whatever. Let's have a quick jab at the time here and then I should be able to decommission it. Indochina, please. Yeah, there it is. Oh, maybe I only looked at the relocate button and not the decommission one. Yep. And then we have the... I also need to rename my planes again. But, I mean, the equipment is rather a standard issue by now. Indochina, let's go. And then we can produce one more Corsair at least. Maybe also with focus lenses, we'll see. Terror soldier disassembly. Camp protection unlikely to be overcome. Kinetic is good. Energy is good. Incendiary is lacking. Comparison. Two ballistic cores. One Caerium. Okay, we don't have that yet, right? And we don't need it as of now. But that might change. Good to know. Really hurting for this reactor right now, but I'm resisting putting more scientists in that. If it only rolls over next wave, well, I don't think we have the torpedoes by this wave anyway. Do we have some of these? Andron and Mech? We have 11 of these. Wow, we can have 11 whatever Caerium is. That's cool, I guess. It should be like the next Elenium, maybe. It's weird that we don't, that we can't research that for now. So do we go for more infantry weapons or do we go for another Corsair? I think Corsair is the answer. There it is. Now we go to the aircraft, equip that with... Oh, do we have more? Okay, one focus lens, one Magstorm. Not the ideal layout. I'm gonna produce another focus lens, actually. Focus lens, there it is. 6 hours. Let me... Oh, there's the reactor, okay. There's the plasma explosives. Great. Do that with all our might. I don't know. I think we don't have to put that... Okay, we have to put that many scientists in. Let's do the 25 here. Because the plasma torpedoes are just so necessary to get down the big ships. And let's also look at... What I wanted to check here is if I... What? Oh, wrong base. If I have two Magstorms, no I don't, just have the one focus lens, one Magstorm. So we might produce another Magstorm or we might put it on the next heavy fighter. Focus lens, give me focus lens, there it is, go to the base. Let's look at the vehicles actually, if we need one more, because they might have been destroyed, right? Why is your ammo level 0? What's up with that? Vehicles. Oh, we just have two. Let's produce another defender, maybe. I think we also like are close to the hover tank with the anti-grav stuff. Are we still doing that? Or did it? No, it didn't yield anything for us. Okay. Yeah. So defender most likely. Because they are cheap. Vehicles and mechs. Oh, light fibers. Who do we need to rip apart for light fibers? Do we have xenomorph dissection? No, we don't. Reapers with toxin glands, which I don't know why we should need that. Do you give light fibers? You do, but we don't have any of you. That should also be something, like it should be grayed out if there's nothing to be done here. Vehicle weapons with plasma bolt. What I'm actually looking at is dense fibers here. only dense fibers, but they should give light fibers, right? Something here. Season officer corps, okay, don't have many of these. Wraith soldier corps. Let's do the officers first. Yeah, the one officer, which will be done fast. And then we can produce another defender. Go to base, give me the defender. And we also need to produce more of them for more upcoming shortages of vehicles, right? There we got the reactors. We started on the plasma explosives, which will yield plasma heavy explosives, and then we will go on from that mag machine gun, please. What? Let's look at the vehicle weapons real quick, because I'm not 100% sure what they did here. Yeah, this is the single shot thing, which means we need to get pretty close. And I'd like my tank to be able to suppress, because killing close range we can still do with this, with these things, right? Division machine gun we don't need. Pulse laser, let's compare these. 22 range, which should be it's a bit better. Range also potentially translates to more accuracy, right? 40 times 10 damage, 45 times 30 with 10 bursts. This has 15. Is a lot of damage in one burst. 30 mitigation, which is also better than this one. Yeah, I think we're gonna stick with the mag machine guns, actually. Even though the enemies, like the normal ones, have higher kinetic resistance. Because we have now one with pulse, one defender, and one with mag, and so we can send the pulse one to sites with Androns. We have a data hack. Mark 3 upgrades for plasma weapons. Ooh, yes. For which weapons? And, okay, these were started at the same time, I think. Modification kit for the plasma grenade. Wow. Okay, so this could play right into our grenade. Our plasma explosive stuff, right? One or more mag Mark 2 into Mark 3. Okay. I didn't know that these could also affect other thing than... Okay, plasma pistol, which is nice. Oh, that's a mag pistol, but also it might be good to check out. Maybe it turns out to get better than 20. So with that, maybe I'm looking into the data hack more. But let's look at the plasma explosives first. Precision plasma Mark 3 sounds so juicy. We're not producing many of these, so I don't really care if they are expensive. Why do we have no scientists in this? No one knows. I mean, officer vivisection isn't like really the most pressing thing we have to do, right? Yeah, let's do this. Also, only with 5. And the mag pistol Mark 3. And then let's look into what more we can do. It might be that these lead into the advanced advanced smoke grenades, which would be worthwhile. So I'm gonna try this, because we can't do that right now, right? Oh, we Don't. It's the wrong base. Oh, but we don't produce here anything here either. Did I re-equip these with focus lenses? Yeah, okay. No production, which is bad. Grenades. We don't have the better smoke grenades yet. Okay. More buzzard armor would also mean more light fiber, but I think we have four of them. Okay, hyper missile takes more than Piranha. We might have to see what they do. I thought Piranha would just be a straight upgrade. Plasma weapons. Let's take one of these or more rifles. Like if I think about it, I have 10 people, right? Let's say 3 of them have miniguns or other suppressive stuff. 2 have shields with pistols. One has maybe a sniper rifle and is a scout. Then the other 5 need rifles. So ideally I would have 10 of these rifles. I have 5 right now. So let's produce more of them, actually. The cores are easy to come by because we have so many robodogs. Yeah, so I want more of these rifles. Hangar, okay, that's nice. Northern Africa has more hangars, so we can actually... What does Northern Africa need? It needs one complete more fighter squad. It has only one. It only built one hangar. Does this suffice? 3, 3, 3, yeah. So it has too many Foxtrots right now. But that will change once the other 2 bases come online. And then start having hangars. Yeah, Astro Asia also needs one more Foxtrot for another bomber team, so this will be alleviated somewhat. But let's finish this. Well, let's put more into this fighter squad. I'm gonna count the Firebird as a fighter equivalent here, and let's decommission this thing and put the other Corsair in there that was Indochina. And then we can think about producing more planes after we have the rifles. And there are more hangars everywhere. Okay, so we can start producing more planes. Disassemble power source, 2 AN alloys, 3 Elenium. That's not so much. I think they sell for a pretty good amount. Okay, 5 scientists. What more can we get here? I think we start the civilian data hack, right? It's gonna be a long shot. Yeah, that's only average. But that's okay. I can wait with that. Let's see how many of these we have. This most likely here. 19 power sources. How much do they sell for? Resources? I don't know what they categorize. Alien power source. Power source. They sell for 5,000 each. Okay, so this would be almost 100,000. I'm gonna keep them. I'm gonna keep them for funds if I need them. It makes more sense to me to disassemble. Do we have something that's produced? Officer vivisection. Battlefield weaknesses. 32 light fibers. That's cool. That's a complete set of armor, basically, from one of these. Since these explosives take so long, I'm gonna bite the bullet and put more scientists in that. Can we do that, actually? This section... Phase 3 is not what we need. Phase 2 civilians. Yeah, we have one officer. That's cool. Then we're gonna put that as the next. Just so we have the light fibers for a tank or for a buzzard suit. Sonder! There it is. Okay, so Sonder has the two normal hard points. So it doesn't really compare to anything. The comparison with Firebird most likely isn't fair. Firebird is still faster, goes farther, has better acceleration and turn rate, but it's like a poor man's... Let's compare that with Foxtrot, actually. Range is 25, okay, which is better than Foxtrot, which they are made to accompany. And all the other stuff is better with Sonder, right? Yeah. But which is good, because they need to circle and need to draw the missiles and torpedoes and stuff. It would be cool to have one a plane that has one normal, one heavy, but I don't think that is happening in phase 2 at least. Yeah, so let's look at what they need to be produced. And let's maybe also do more of these interrogations. Advanced stun grenade maybe also? Yeah. Sounds good. We wanted to look at the production of Sonder. Oh, looks quite cheap. Corsair needs more engines, less computers. This needs a control system. Yeah, so it's basically a heavy fighter without the need for the heavy fighter itself, right? Cool. Yeah, we can do a couple of these. And then start equipping bomber squads with them where we expect like really huge UFOs. Yeah, I know. I've been thinking about this outpost a bit. So we could rate this, right? And see what we get, but we get phase 2 stuff, and it's a high stakes game, so it's a really huge mission, which might bring us losses even with the better equipment that we have, because our armors aren't as good. But if we wait too long, this at some point will turn into a base, right? Once we have Predator armor, I'm not too shy taking outposts anymore, because I feel that by then our armor is stacked so high and our weapons are also that good that we can take one of these. But until then, like basically what I'm contemplating here is taking it now for the resources for the outpost reactor stuff that sells for almost a million. Stuff like this, and also maybe we'll find something like a civilian engineer, which we need. Just for the loots, basically. Or we wait, which makes this into a base at some point, because we might not be able to catch these supply ships all the time. Which then would mean... on the one hand, that we have a thing that we cannot reasonably deal with right now, maybe, or with just very high risks. But on the other hand, I want an AM base before phase 3 to pre-research the phase 3 stuff as much as we can without planes, right? Like the weapons which we have right now, the blood cannons and toxin and whatever, dark, all that stuff. I want to be able to research that before phase 3 comes. It will be hard enough to have the phase 3 airgame with only phase 2 planes, which is inevitable, really, because you only get the aircraft upgrades with the new UFOs, for the most part, I think. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna leave that until we have enough Predator armor. That's my current current view of this thing. But when another outpost spawns, we will need to destroy one of them, right? If we don't, like over here where we had to abort the mission, but the outpost didn't spawn. Like, if that thing had been there, I would be gearing up for an outpost right now. But the more high-tech equip I have, the more confident I feel in it. Advanced stun rocket. Okay, let's look at that thing. But first of all, let's see what we can research here. Max Storm Mark III might be worthwhile. I don't think we have the Max Storm Mark II yet, right? I mean that we didn't produce any. 20 on 16 range, 15 on 60 range, 6 accuracy times 60 shots, 8 accuracy times 60 shots, 65, 65. Suppression 100, suppression 102, okay, so this increase is negligible. Ammo cap 240 stays the same. So I'm gonna research that, and if it makes a worthwhile contribution over these two, then I'm gonna contemplate basically producing one or two of these. Not in this base. Where is it here? That could also be easier, that this is like less distributed. Advanced stun rocket. I'm not gonna produce that right now, but what I want to do is look at it. Equipment rockets. We have this one with 60 stun and 5 chem, mitigation of 10. Let's look at the raw numbers first. 90 stun and still 5 chem, mitigation 30. Okay, that's pretty nice. But it's, I think, mitigation for chem, not for the stun, right? Because chem is its main damage type. And that should be the... I think stun doesn't even have an armor value assigned to it, but chem does. Smoke of 85%, smoke of 75. 35% dissipation, 35, and accuracy reduction of... So it spawns the smoke to 85%, which is better than here. The smoke has 60 stun damage instead of the 30, which is cool, and it has an accuracy reduction by shooting through it. Yeah, okay, so let's look at what these cost to produce, right? Rockets, advanced stun rocket, advanced AN stun grenades and AN alloys, and gives 2 stun rockets. So if we produce like, if we produce like this thing 5 times, we still have enough advanced AN stun grenades for our grenades and stuff. But we also will have a good amount of these things. Let's compare that with the shock rocket, actually. That's also something I wanted to do. 90 stun. I'm looking at the stun value here. 160 stun. Wow, okay. So this actually has more stun. But the... I think the stun gas doesn't work as it should, right? It has 70 stun. This has 60. So, okay, in theory, you shouldn't ever take this thing, right? Even if you were bent on stunning, because this thing just produces more stun. Mitigation 15, mitigation 30. So advanced shock rocket might be the thing to turn to in the future. I don't understand that actually. Like even like if these values applied, then it would also would always be better to have shock rockets instead of stun rockets, right? Is it because stun rockets are hard to produce? Shock rockets? No, they're dirt easy. You don't even need the grenades for them. I mean, they cost more alloys, okay, granted. And you only produce one. Yeah, maybe they are harder to produce. But not by so much that they that a phase one thing, I think it's phase one or early phase two, should trump that. I don't know what's up with these values. Even so, I wouldn't bother doing this if these values were correct, but the shock rocket gas doesn't stun. So it doesn't do anything against enemies or, I don't know, soldiers maybe, that walk through that. I think it has the EMP value, though I might be wrong on that. Yeah, but basically this doesn't work as intended. And the dissipation is much faster here, so with this you can lock down enemies longer, which is also nice. Radius of 4.5, radius of 4.0, okay. Yeah, we're gonna produce some of these, and if it's Andron high stakes missions, we might bring the EMP rockets, and for the other things we bring the other stuff. We are going to the moon and do the other things. Ooh, Firebird is operational. Okay, so we are looking right now at a time where it seems that downed planes get their health back, which is great. Because that's something I feared after our last disastrous air game. Yeah, we're getting health back. So like 24 hours more until the next wave comes and there will be fully operational. There's the advanced stun rocket. Now, do we produce some sonders and have bomber squads with one sonder, one heavy fighter is the question. Yeah, I think so. I think we do that. And then we put anti-missiles and something like piranhas on them. Let's actually look at what the best mass spam missiles for that are. Like we have the piranha, which is 17 ammo cap, okay. That's not much. That's 50 with here. DC. I mean, it should still suffice, right? And they should do more damage, maybe. Anti-missile? Oh, yeah, okay. I think it's like anti-meta missile. It was, whoa, we do have something like this. Hypermissile has more damage potential if they get through. 600 rounds per minute is the same, so Piranha is more fast firing. But overall, I think we're looking at hypermissiles right now. Unless we can research something that is we might, after the plasma explosives, we might have some plasma rockets that do something like this. Xenomorph DNA analysis. Okay. Normal xenomorph units are hatched from civilian captives. Normal Praetorians hatch from wraiths. Okay. Queens start as Praetorians and rapidly metamorphose. Morph, maybe, just. Weakness in Reapers, not Xenomorphs, allowing our troops to deal a little more damage. Okay. Should allow us to start research on heavy chem gas, which we are doing the advanced right now. Okay. So this might also... I mean, I don't know what other prerequisites this has, right? Okay, so if you have a facehugger actually like infecting someone, There comes a Praetorian out of that. Out of the zombie that comes from that. Then there will be a low-level Praetorian. And Praetorian gradually gets stronger until it morphs into a queen, and this also gets stronger. So we should kill them soon. I'm trying to actually kill the facehugger before it becomes a problem. most times. With this possibility of having heavy chemgas gas. Maybe let's speed that up a bit. Mag Precision Mark II might also be something to look into. Now there's the Sonder. Yeah, two Sidewinders. Hyper missile and titanium anti missile, which is cool because now we can send away one heavy fighter, and in the main base we will have the modern, like apart from Lancer, the modern equipment for our bomber squad, right? The thing that I'm considering most optimal. Let's look at a base that could take a heavy fighter still. Okay, this one, Indochina. Definitely right. Indochina has its bomber squad, but with a heavy fighter and Firebird. So we might look into sending away this Foxtrot to maybe Australasia, because I'm seeing in the future more fighting on the Asian continent than in Australia. Can we send it to Australasia? We can. Which doesn't have a second bomber squad yet. And then we can send this heavy fighter to Indochina, was it right? Yeah. Okay, cool. We have one Azero still in main base here. Where do we need more fighters? Northern Africa? Looking at my cheat sheet here. Yeah, we do. We do need a second fighter squad here, and we need to redistribute more of the Foxtrots from here. So let's start with that. Relocate this thing to Northern Africa. Okay, let's actually check if we want to build more stuff. This thing goes online in 4 days, which will be most likely after the next wave. Could have one more hangar for the Firebird here, but we might need the space for more labs. But we might also have another base build up lab infrastructure, which wouldn't be too bad. Yeah, I'm more fond of that actually. And the labs will increase in their capacity also at some point. At which point the personal capacity will be the bottleneck. Why do we have a storeroom here? Do we need that actually? Can we scrap that? Do we have anything of any quantity in here? We do have some Mausers and Elenium missiles and a Gatling laser. Could send that to main base and then just scrap the... Oh, we can't unequip stuff from airplanes that way, right? We could sell the Mausers. And also sell the Elenium missiles, we are not gonna need more of them. And Gatling laser is not a... So yeah, we sell all of that. And then we should be able to scrap the storeroom, right? And then we can produce a fourth plasma battery here, which is rather cheap. And also another hangar for the planes. Yeah, and we might scrap these ones once this circle gets bigger. Ooh. Okay, we have a large UFO, which is like a cruiser, and two planes accompanying it. And I'm gonna wait for more spawns here and to decide. Two very okay, normal fighter squadron. What next? A light cruiser with ground attack mission. With robo stuff again. What can we intercept that with? Two heavy fighters and a Foxtrot, it seems. Let's send them. Right away. There's a medium. A medium can be almost taken down by three Azeos. It can definitely be taken down by like a Corsair squad or stuff. Now we're about to have two bomber squads here. Yeah, let's send these. I think that should suffice. Maybe we actually send a normal bomber squad in there. I don't think a third big UFO will spawn here. I mean, it might be. There's a medium. Where is that? Over here with Gleitschutz, as we say. Send the Azeros in to try and take away their stuffs. Ooh, Northern Africa will have a bad stance against this. Maybe these ones should actually try to get these auxiliaries. What does Australia? Yeah, let's send these ones here. This might be the supply ship actually. And these ones, the Squadron 6, should go there. I don't. It would be cool if you had like the maximum radius, right? This shouldn't be a supply ship, but this might just be the supply ship. Oh, we still have these ones here. Let's intercept them with three Azeos from down here. And then I think there should be one more UFO, or no? Is it 4 plus 1 because of the outpost, or is it 5 plus 1? I think it's 4 plus 1 actually. And for the large one we will send a bomber squad from main base. Is this overland? It is. Yeah, let's just try that. Yeah, let's send the Foxtrot away actually, so it isn't considered a threat here.
Who has it?
Yeah, okay, that's good. Roll outward a bit, so the strike covert. Ooh, and wants to turn more, so the Foxtrot needs to go. Oh no, it doesn't. Okay, perfect. Get in here. Lock your torpedoes for now. I'm more fond of shooting them. Like this heavy fighter should actually go down here and attack it from down here. So if it is targeted by the strike corvette, then it turns downward. Ooh, okay. Oh, you should go more over here. Okay, strike corvette is turning. I need you to go in here. And I need you to start firing.
Group 2receiving.
I want the fire to be concentrating on this thing, so I'm gonna turn on afterburner here. Okay, it's not. You just turn inward too. We need to. I mean, this is two torpedoes already. I think we might be able to turn out here. Okay. Nice. No damage until now. Turn off the afterburner.
Roger that sweep.
Go after after you turned outward. Go after the strike corvette. Okay. Oh yeah, it shot once. How much damage does it have? 56. Yeah, that's. Oh, we have an autocannon here. That's bad. Let's return here, actually. Don't X return, because the strike corvette is turning. Turn there. You fire another torpedo. And it turns the other way. So you turn away and then go here. What are you doing? Torpedoes away. If we could get the fourth one firing, that would be nice. Okay, now okay, Foxtrot can definitely go out. Where is the nearest? Let's go there. Let's try that. What are you doing? Go in. You turn away. Yeah, okay, torpedoes are still hitting. That's nice. Okay, there it is. A bit of damage on the Foxtrot, that's okay. And we have a mission, which is a robo mission. And it is 1940. I'm looking at the clock because I need to remember that in case we only do it next day. Yeah, this one is on a bomb or ground attack. Okay, bombing mission, yeah. This one might be hard to catch actually by these planes. There's the heavy fighter against Azeros battle. 1 second away. Target acquired, charging for first. So you go a bit slower. A tiny bit slower. So you can catch up. One can start accelerating again. Two can start accelerating again. Now we have all three planes on top of each other. Now we can turn down here. Which one isn't down there yet? Okay, now we turn to slow. Slow mode. Yeah, I think we got that. I want this one to turn first, this one also to turn. This one will take a short amount of time and then turn. Okay, one is down. It's nice. This is almost down, so now we start turning again. Maybe even since they are starting to turn this way, we will roll this way to get there faster. Yeah, roll. And now we actually go down here. Let's turn you over this way. Don't know if we can actually get that right now. Just waiting for the cool off of the rolls. So you roll, and they should both get this thing. Yeah, nice. And now you just attack and we'll see. Okay, it's turning this way. That's nice. Because that means this one can turn right out here. These two just have rolled. You roll inwards, so you can get there faster. You don't have a roll still. Okay, nice. Okay, all a bit damaged, but that's nothing we can't handle. Nice, nice. I'm pretty happy about how this air game goes for now. But I think we might want to... This might be a, not with a large, not a base attack with a large. And do we have anything to intercept this? We have two heavy fighters and an Azeros here, which might make short work of their compadres, and then we can have them go there. And we also send a I like this strike team there, I think. It's a bit overkill, but that's okay. And we have the Firebird basically. Let's put out the Firebird, Indochina base. Launch interceptors. And there, the Firebird. So it can still get this thing. I'm pretty convinced that this will try to supply. Yeah, it's a landing ship. And we engage. Oh yeah, that's really bad. Yeah. We all roll here, we all go here, and we're gonna try to get them as quickly as possible. That's not what I meant. One, please go a bit slower. And then we all turn this way. Not yet, maybe. I mean, turning takes a bit of time, right? Now we're going over here. Gonna do a half turn first. One can go fast again. And now we turn completely over here. Like this. Now we should have the first one in the back, but we're gonna take it slow here. Let's go over here, and we might be able to just ride straight ahead, strafe the third one. This one should be dead. Yep, that's dead. You, please don't. Please go more over here. One turning. Two and three turning now. Maybe that was a bit early, but it should be sufficient. And now you just go get out. Where's the shortest way? Most likely over here, even though you have to turn to do that. And we might lose the squad, but that's just what we have to do, right? And we can go more speedy. Okay, one barely lost. But that's okay. So now these can again. No, that's. Are you the bomber squad? Heavy fighter, Corsair? Nope. Then. No, you can actually shoot this thing down. Maybe this squad isn't needed, but we're gonna send it anyway. Yep. That's okay. Patrol there. You're the failsafe. Should we for some reason not get this? Okay, we're going right in. Gonna need the afterburner here. Okay, now it's doing whatever. Okay, oh shit, I didn't mean to press the roll button actually. And we're gonna take it slow now, because I don't know what it shoots. Okay, it shoots small thingies. Roll out here. You roll out here and go here. Oh, that's our mech storm that shoots like this. What are you doing here? Attack. Attack. Straight on attack. Heavy fighter, turn away. 43 damage. The turning isn't really good, turning radius. But the mech storm is doing good work here. The focus lenders also, I think. Once they shoot, yeah, that's a nice burst damage. I should have stayed in there actually with the focus lenses. It was a mistake. Okay, that's down, but that focus lens burst, yeah. Good, good. I'm happy with that. This is looking good. If you say so. I don't know what these are, but we're gonna take that mission. Most likely. Maybe let's still check this one. Where is this UFO going? Can we... Do we have anything? 3 foxtrots. I mean... No, the I-0s will be up, so... maybe 2 I-0s and a foxtrot or something like this. Maybe even 3 foxtrots. If it's necessary. It's overland. Oh yeah, it's this one. Yeah, let's engage. Let's go. It's a bad situation here. We're going to have to run away basically here.
We have a situation developing here.
And the fighters are far faster than the I-0s. We're going to roll out of its way first. I think we have the I-0s more as a go in there and blast the thing than the typical we are rolling into them plane, because these two will have to do that. Roll in, target this, roll in, target this, and we'll see what kind of damage you can do here. 36%, not too good. .51, .58, it's pretty good. You go over here, you bait this one. We might end up in the big radius of the bomber cruiser here, which would be bad. And we're gonna take this heads on here. Ooh, whoa, that's a fast turn. Okay. But I think the Azios should be able to get it still. What are you doing? I'm just sped you up, okay. Oh, you are just also slow. You turn inwards, you also turn inwards, we need that right now. And this is the saving grace for them. This is this one, you go out here. You also turn here immediately, we can't stay in this large radius, I presume. Oh, it has missiles. Okay, that's just a missile radius. We can totally stay in that. Critical damage. That's nice. You turn away. You turn this way, because I don't care for missiles. And you get over here. You get in here. That's a risk for the I-0s, obviously, right? You can just turn inwards now. Oh, that was the wrong direction. No, it was wrong. I'm a moron. Okay. So, you get out here. And you also fly away now. We might need normal speed here for the anti-missile stuffs to work. Oh, you speed up, please. Okay. Nice.
Let's wrap this up.
Just, I mean, I'm always glad, unless the planes are shot down. Sonder 1 is rearming, okay. I think we have the time to let it rearm shortly. That's Azeros. There's no way to know what is rearmed here, right? And I absolutely need the anti-missile, so I'm not in a place to play around with that, basically. You just return to your base. And though your fuel level doesn't look too bad. Oh, does it? Is it turned around just before land? Oh, come on. Okay, we might shoot that down into the ocean. because I'm not gonna let it bomb more stuff. I mean, basically, I should equip a team for this medium mission now, and one for this one because it's a short flight, and then we would send whatever comes back first to this one. That should theoretically be the plan. 79%. Yeah, just auto resolve. I don't want my stuff to be shut down here. You go over here, you turn there, you go here.
Heavy fire confirmed.
Don't forget we have the one heavy fighter which only has an autocannon, which is bad. Light cruiser doesn't seem to have missiles. Oh no, it's turning! You get away! Is it turning towards you? What is it doing? Oh yeah, okay, it switched targets again. That's nice. Switching targets again, that's less nice. Well, what are you going after? Like, we are in your back now. Are you going after the Foxtrot series? Turn this way. Nope, you are not. You are? You are not. Okay, Foxtrot, reassemble. It has a good turning speed. That much I'm gonna give it. So maybe stop the torpedoes for now. Okay, that's nice. Even though your radius doesn't imply that in the slightest, but I'm gonna take it. Ooh, that was a huge amount of damage. I just zoned out here a bit. So maybe it's not the smartest thing to fly through that, and maybe I should actually start these.
Roger that, we've got your beacon.
What do you do with my bacon? Ooh yeah, it has anti-missiles, that's bad. But I think still that two torpedoes should go through, right, at this stage. You just get out. Maybe you don't get out. Okay. Okay. We have one heavy fighter left. That's the problem when you target the UFO. Your ship is prone to getting too slow. Speed up. Come on, turn. 91 critical, but it might not be enough. Because I can't turn. Okay, so that's a full wipe. That's less than ideal. As I say. Three Foxtrots bum rushing over sea. So infuriating. I think I'm gonna send the three Foxtrots against this thing actually. Officer interrogation. We already read this, I think. Okay, no new data hack from that. Disappoint. Capture an alien leader, and is this now the goal here? Oh, it should tell me down there when the Sonder is rearmed. It's basically right now. Let's go, boys! And now this isn't daylight. Yeah, I need to... Oh, this thing comes down again. I need to go get on this mission, like, right away. I think we're gonna play the rest in the next episode. So, thanks for watching. I hope you are on the Xenonauts train the next time. And until then, be excellent to each other. Bye-bye.